Welcome back to the Healthcare Uncomplicated YouTube channel. Before I go ahead with another episode, make sure you subscribe to the channel and also check all the previous content. Today I have another magnificent guest for you. Today we have Nicholas Conn. He's the founder and chief scientific officer at Casana. Nick, how are you?
I'm doing great, João. Thank you so much for having me.
Brilliant. Before the recording, we talked about your great innovation. As you know, I've been following your great work, so I'm delighted to have you here. Thank you so much for accepting my invite.
Of course. Excited to speak about what we do.
Brilliant. And today we are addressing the topic, the future of healthcare, where you least expect it. And Nick, can you tell us more about Casana, your amazing innovation, the smart toilet, and your heart seat, please?
Of course. So as you mentioned, we have a smart toilet seat. And what's unique about it is that it monitors your heart health. We're not looking at waste. We're not looking at what comes out of the body, but we're looking at your cardiovascular health every time you sit down. So Casana was formed to go after this passion of bringing medical grade technology to the home where people can benefit from it in such a way that clinicians can use the information that we gather and track to improve care. So healthcare where you least expect it, on your toilet seat. But it's beautiful in the form factor because we don't have to have people learn a new habit to use our technology. And that's the core of what we do here at Casana, is trying to make things effortless, not just for the provider, but also for the patient.
Oh, that's fantastic. And is into the environment, the comfort at home is perfect. It's very, very out of the box, very innovative, because we are used to the wearables that are the smart bands, the smart watches. Things are really evolving. Moving on, what do you think are the best ways to capture health data and monitor people?
So the best way to capture health data is in habits people already have. While wearable devices are super interesting and the technology can be very impressive, you still have to remember to charge the device, to put it on. Most of them require a smartphone in order to be able to communicate with it. And for those with advanced disease, such as cardiovascular disease, they may not be highly technically literate. They may not have a smartphone. And I, even somebody who I like to think is highly technically illiterate, I can't be bothered to charge my devices. So figuring out ways to integrate things into people's everyday lives is the best way to measure data. And on top of that, one of the other benefits of our form factor is that people are still, unlike a wearable where you're being monitored as you go about your everyday life, it's very uncontrolled. Yet when you sit down on a toilet seat, it's probably the most still that you are for that day. And being able to capture vital signs in that state enables us to measure things with really high degrees of accuracy and things that otherwise would be not available in a wearable device.
Brilliant. Nick, I really like that because, as you know, I'm interested in wearables, and also I carry out a 159 pages report, and we came out with five device-related barriers and five user-related barriers. The user-related barriers, the top three, include battery issues, forgetfulness, because the human behavior, the things that you mentioned are really, really important, embedded in your day-to-day life. The behavior is always the tricky thing. It's like forming a new habit to go to the gym or doing a new activity. So what you're doing is really, really great because everybody needs to go to the toilet. And I really like what you mentioned as well, being still at that moment, because even the wearable, we're always in a rush, you might check and don't pay attention to it. Yeah, it's really magnificent. Moving on to the third and last question is, how do you foresee the future of healthcare?
So we have a proliferation of sensors that are finding their way onto people's bodies and into their home. And it is going to be a challenge for clinicians to work with this deluge of data. So the future of healthcare, I see technology is coming together to be able to provide more actionable insights to clinicians, devices that push the boundary of not just monitoring a specific vital sign or condition, but providing recommendations, also interacting with one another to look at filling in this mosaic of somebody's life, not just knowing what their heart rate or blood pressure is every day, but pairing that data with, say, sleep data, fitness tracking. By looking at these multiple different data streams and providing the context to clinicians, we believe that it's possible at Casana to avoid this data overload while still providing really valuable insights on people's everyday lives. So I think that's where the industry is going, and we're going to really see a lot of care move from the hospital or even the clinic into the home as we increase these capabilities in a way that are not burdensome to the clinician as well.
Fantastic. You are very right. Things are moving into a different direction to home care and with the sensors, wearables, environmental data. Yeah, I was at last IMS and at Vive, and it's a lot of talk about home care and community care, the outside of the four walls of the hospital, if you like. Nick, we could talk for hours about wearables, about innovation, about healthcare. I keep my interviews quite sharp, but I have one last, it's not a question, I have one last little surprise question for you, if you like. It's, how can we make healthcare uncomplicated?
It's really thinking about the partnership, because there are so many different places and people that touch the healthcare journey of an individual. It's not just the person who may have a condition like hypertension. It's their loved ones. It's their caretakers. It's their primary care provider. It's all of these other people who support their care journey, and working together and looking at every single piece of this. Really, it's a village that helps keep people healthy. You can find ways to reduce friction, to make things a little bit more pleasant, and hopefully improve outcomes for the folks while you do this.
Fantastic. Magnificent way to round up. Nick, again, thank you so much. And please keep me updated with all the developments. You know, I'm very interested in what you are doing, and I follow it very, very closely. Thank you so much for the interview, for these magnificent insights, and the brilliance around your brilliant work and innovation at Casana.
Thank you, João. Follow us on LinkedIn, and we will definitely be staying in touch.
Brilliant. I'm going to round up now. To all our viewers and listeners, make sure you subscribe to the channel. Also, I'm going to post Nick's Casana's website, the innovation, and his LinkedIn. Reach out to him. Ask him questions about his innovation and magnificent contribution to the future of healthcare. Acknowledge also our partners, and I'll see you all next week.